Joining me from Massachusetts is Ravi Ramamurthy. He's director of the Center for Emerging Markets at Northeastern University. Give me your takeaways from what we learned about the second day of the BRICS Summit.
Well, I think the most important outcome is the fact that you have the leaders of these five countries speaking in unison. In this year, the big issue has been the rise of unilateralism and protectionism, and they've taken a strong stance, all of them, on that issue. And I think the great thing about the summit, it provides the opportunity for the emerging economies to sometimes, on issues on which they tend to agree across the five countries, to take a strong position and express it in a very effective way.
Yeah, one of the tenets that emerged from their declaration read that they are committed to strengthening multilateralism, reforming global governance, and addressing common challenges. Talk to us about some of the common challenges that these nations face.
Well, they're all developing at different levels of development. So they are looking to connect to the global economy and use that as a way to speed up their development. You know, there was a time when poor countries thought globalization was going to hurt them. Today is very much the opposite situation. They're very convinced that being a part of a global economy is the way to advance development even faster. So in order to do that, they need to have a global economy that continues to be open, that continues to be fair, and that is governed by some rules. What we are witnessing now is that potentially a threat to the entire infrastructure that's been developed over the last 30 or 40 years and the climate that has been created that's made it possible for countries like China to develop as rapidly as it has, or countries like India to develop as rapidly as it has. So it's very important for them that this system be preserved.
Ravi, China's President Xi Jinping, in his address, kicking things off, said we must unlock the enormous potential of our economic cooperation. Is BRICS doing that? Where are some of the areas where they've been successful, making strides, and where do they still need to do some work?
Yeah, I think that is more of a challenge than people like to admit. Right now, China is the strongest of the five economies. In fact, its GDP is more than the sum of the GDPs of the other four countries. And over time, this difference is going to get even larger. And therefore, they're going to have some difficulty trying to figure out what is it that this club can do that is of mutual advantage to all countries. It's very clear that for China, such an association is an important way of continuing to expand its influence and its economic strength. But for some of the other smaller players, whether it's Brazil or Russia or South Africa, and even for India, it's not quite clear how they can cooperate more. But I think the value of these summits is that it provides an opportunity for the member countries on a bilateral basis to look for ways to deepen their relationship and smooth out any rough edges in their relationship. I think that's a good thing. It doesn't by itself create a very strong economic bond. These countries are geographically distant from one another. They're not all natural trading partners. So it's going to be hard to find a way to actually deepen the economic relationship.
Each country gets... go ahead, I'm sorry.
Yeah. No, at the same time, I think having an opportunity to explore ways to do this, to have people-to-people exchanges, to share technologies, find ways to create new market opportunities across the BRICS countries is a good thing.
I was going to ask you, each year, each country gets a chance to host this. How has this year's meeting been different from last year's gathering, which took place in China and Xiamen, would you say?
I think the most important difference this year is that because it's taking place in Africa, several other African countries have been invited to participate in the proceedings. And I think that is another aspect of these annual summits, that each time they go to a new location, they also invite some other countries who are not permanent members of this club to join them and engage in this conversation come up with some mutually beneficial ideas. Africa is a very important continent. It has enormous potential going forward. So to use this summit as a way also to connect with some of the other key countries in the continent, I think is very beneficial.
Ravi Ramamurthy joining us from Massachusetts. Thanks so much.